So, I got a small update on the FGC6 BL or H, but H is not released yet because I don't have the time to make the manual. But as you can see right here, you can see that the wheel on the hammer is now just a roller bearing. This is something that did pop in my mind when I was kind of designing it, like, oh, it would be nice, but I did not really put much thinking further into it, I kind of forgot about it, to be honest, later on, to kind of look into it, because at first I was thinking like, oh, it would be kind of really small, let's say, but later when you think about it, there are things that got really small roller bearings, so that doesn't really make that much sense. But anyways, I have released the BL and the H is also working and testing with just a plastic wheel. And if you do the, let's say, specs right, so the bolt that you screw the wheel in is not too tight, it's nice and smooth, things like that, it should work good enough. But of course, it cannot beat the use of a roller bearing. So it also makes it more easier to do. It's basically, you can use the stock, let's say, hammer that you already printed, in case you already built one, and just remove the wheel by removing the bolt, and then just take a roller bearing and use this flathead screw. I will give the correct size. This one, to be honest, is too small in length, but still seems to work fine. But if I really want to put this one to use, to spaces, let's say with hot weather, things like that, I would want to make the bolt longer, but I have to wait until that one arrives. But I can already tell it works. If you do use it on the stock hammer, it seems to work fine. But it is also depending on how the roller bearing is made. But if you bolt it too tight, it may kind of force the wheel against the hammer and give friction that way. So a solution to that can be to give it one, let's say, a quarter turn back from all the way tight, and then a little bit loose and feel like, okay, now it's smooth again. But of course, in my mind at least, this maybe give a little bit of a movement in the wheel. I do have to say, I don't really notice it. And maybe a little bit more friction. I do have to say, I do not really notice it. But I've made an improved, let's say, or special made hammer. So that one will have a little groove. The gap is so small that I don't think that you can see it. But it just gives it a little bit of a gap, and it will rest the roller bearing in the center, let's say, on this side of the hammer. So it got no friction, let's say, against the hammer. And that's basically the only difference between the two hammers. That it got a little bit of a cutout for it, and a little bit of a pin. So it's kind of rested on the hammer, instead of only hold it in center by the bolt head. But it doesn't seem to give any issues, and with the other two people that kind of use this, and it's also more their idea to do this in the first place, because I was too busy to kind of work on this project, but I did kind of read in the comments where they are working on. It's also thanks to them that this update is there. So besides this wheel, you don't have to change anything on the design of your BLL or H. It all stays the same. It just makes this wheel a little bit more smoother to use. So it will make your action run more smoothly. So hopefully give it just a little bit more reliability than before. And that's basically it. I don't think later on I will probably edit it in the manual. But for now it's just a video update. And I will put this part in a special folder in the basic file download, let's say. So you can download it from there. And Hopefully it makes your BL age work better than before. Also about the age, I hope that I can kind of make some time for it in the winter to kind of work on manual and release the age model. In case I have not really clarified this, in order for me to make the hammer function, hammer blocking function work, let's say the disconnect, in case you have an empty magazine, I did need to change the lower a bit. So in the beginning I was kind of with the promise and kind of the idea like, okay, the lower stays the same and things like that. But there were some things that I kind of needed to change. Now I do have to say it's been so long a time ago that I really looked at the files that I also maybe think the upper was a little bit different. I believe that I did have updated it already. Yeah, I believe I did so in the about the FGCC 6 PDF, and there you can read the compatibility of uppers and lowers between all the projects. So in case you kind of want to keep updated with that and kind of see what parts you would need to pre-print, and if you find it worth it to wait for the age, or that you already want to build the BL, that's up to you. But yeah, that's it. Hopefully I can release it pretty soon, but there's so many things going on, and the paid projects have priority of the free projects, so yeah, that's how it is. But yeah, see you guys next time. So I'll kind of show a close-up of how the wheel works, but at the same time it's the same as before. As you can see, the wheel will interact continuously with the bolt. Even when the hammer is pushed down, you cannot really see it anymore, but then still the wheel will ride against the bolt that goes over it. So that's why making that more smoothly is definitely worth it. And it's easy to install, so it basically, okay, you need to look for more parts and buy more parts, but it does make it the assembly process a little bit more faster to do, and that you know even that part is smooth, so there's less parts to worry about.